evening, everybody, and a very warm welcome to the Laidlaw Music Centre for this special concert tonight. We are delighted to welcome the Kentucky Wesleyan singers from the US, who will be joined by St. Salvator's Chapel Choir from the University of St. Andrews in a joint concert. And also a very big welcome to anyone in the US who's watching on the live stream. Tomorrow, if you are in St. Andrews, please do join us here at 6 o'clock and at 8 o'clock for a workshop and concert by Musicaly, which is a renowned male voice ensemble from Georgia. Discover the music of Western Georgia in a workshop for all. No music reading skills required. So anyone can come along to that, whether you read music or not, at 6 o'clock and then the concert at 8 tomorrow. We have a retiring collection at the end of today's concert in aid of STAMP, which is our St. Andrews Music Participation Project, which gets lots of children from the local area involved in music through singing and through a big brass project. So that's where your collection is going tonight. And if you enjoy tonight, please come again on Monday when St. Salvator's Chapel Choir will be here again, and then we will be joined by Maryville College Choir from Tennessee. But please give a very warm welcome to the Kentucky Wesleyan Singers.
Hallelujah. great privilege not only to be in your beautiful country, but to be on this stage with such an honored and acclaimed choir as is behind them. We are just delighted to be here and to be in this beautifully beautiful room that is as acoustically perfect as any room that we've sung in. It's just absolutely so wonderful to be here. This next piece that we're going to do was written by a former director of this choir. It's a setting of The Prayer of St. Francis by Paul E. Oakley. This tour is a chance for us to connect to your country and to your people. Our part of the world was actually settled by Scotch-Irish immigrants mostly, and the eastern part of our country, of our state in the southern Appalachian Mountains, is highly Scotch-Irish in culture, and it represents so many of the waves of immigration that happened. As I look around here, only economic downfalls would be the only reason you would ever leave this country in the first place, because it's just so beautiful here. But many times, especially in the early 1700s and in the 1800s, there were economic downturns that forced many people to leave this country and find another place to plant their lives and to make a new start. They brought with them a number of folk tunes, a number of hymn tunes, that went to the mountains in southern Appalachia and became part of the hymnody of those churches. One, we're going to sing two of those right now, arrangements of Pisgah, which is When I Can Read My Title Clear, and Samanthra. Both of those are Scottish melodies and really named after places in Scotland. And we will be singing arrangements by Alice Parker. Settlers, and this next one is a haunting mountain kind of melody that his voice is the sound of a dulcimer sweet.
Thank you.
to sing a Scottish song to Scottish people is really for us, so we get to do that here in this place. This is supposedly the last thing that Mary Queen of Scots wrote, When I No More Behold You, Think on Me. Written by, this arrangement is by one of our Irish-American composers that lives in Indiana, just north of us.
Thank you.
like this folk song that we're getting ready to sing. And coming here, we just had to do it. This is an arrangement by Desmond Early, who's at the University of Dublin, actually, that did this arrangement for us. The Parting Glass, when I was reading about it, it's not only just closing the pub at night, but it is also a song that was used when people were leaving where they lived and going to start a new life in another place. So we sing A Parting Glass as part of all of that. Our soloist is Brooks Holly. Our town houses the National Bluegrass Museum. So we are, bluegrass started like 40 miles south of where we live, and we have the National Bluegrass Museum in our town. So bluegrass is part of what they know too. So we're gonna sing one more piece for you. It is actually a song that was sung in church, but a really bluegrass style. Will the circle be unbroken?
There's a
programme this evening spans the church's year. So that was a piece for Advent, and we're now going to sing you two Christmas pieces. So sorry about that. But yeah, so the first is a traditional folk song down in yon forest, which was associated with Corpus Christi for a long time. In the medieval times, the text was written, and then two extra verses were added, which makes it a bit more Christmassy. And then a really fun arrangement of Tomorrow Shall Be My Dancing Day.
Thank you.
while the organist has his assistant go upstairs. Of for you dedicated to Mary, the mother of Jesus. The first is a short movement from The Veil of the Temple by Sir John Taverner, which is an overnight vigil. The piece has only been performed a handful of times in its entirety. It starts at about 10 o'clock in the evening and finishes at about 5 a.m. in the morning, if you do the full bit. But this is just a short bit from it. And then from Rachmaninoff's Vespers, Bogorodice Dievo.
Thank you.
two pieces with just us. We move to Eastertide. The Wilkes, Hosanna to the Son of David, is as Jesus came into Jerusalem on the donkey being proclaimed by all the people in Jerusalem. And the final piece by Stamford, Chelos Ascendit, is for Ascension Tide. And although it's written by a Victorian composer, matches the kind of style of the Wilkes quite well. Hopefully, we'll all be joined by Kentucky Wesleyan singers, and we would like to finish our concert today by singing a piece together with the combined forces, which I haven't counted how many it is, but it's quite a lot of singers, I think. And we are going to sing Parry, I Was Glad, which seems very fitting given that it was the coronation of King Charles III only just on Saturday. And this was sung, it was the very first piece in the coronation ceremony itself.
Thank you.
afraid, folks. Thank you ever so much for coming and joining us today. It's been a pleasure, Kentucky, having you here. Absolutely brilliant singing. Thank you so much for letting us sing in your concert with you. Okay. So, great, and I think we're all going out for dinner, aren't we? Yes. Okay. Thank you very much for coming, everybody.
Thank you.